Well, because it's October, the social justice warriors and their useful idiots in the left-wing mainstream media are out in force screaming about, you guessed it, so-called culturally appropriated Halloween costumes. Hey folks, check out this recent CBC drive-by slamming of the costume shop business. The good news, according to the CBC and its headline, is that Halloween stores are starting to get the cultural appropriation message. The bad news, alas, is that according to an Indigenous social media activist, offensive costumes can still be found. You know, I've long said that what we really need more of is Indigenous social media activists, but I digress. Some shops have caved to the pressure to remove certain costumes from the shelves, but a shout out to the spirit chain of Halloween shops for not caving into this social justice warrior nonsense. Now, check out this quote from a Vancouver costume shop manager who said, quote, "We sell everything. We're a costume store," end quote. Well, exactly. That's what Halloween is all about. A night in which you embrace something different from what you are, or for that matter, what you identify as. But it is 2017, so we have to change for the sake of change, or for the fear that something out there offends somebody, maybe, perhaps. Which is why the CBC applauds the Malabar Costume Shop in Toronto for its new politically correct costume policy, in which the store now steers clear of costumes related to cultures, i.e. an Indian headdress, a Mexican poncho, etc. As if Halloween costumes are contraband or something. But just look at this photograph of that very same Malabar shop. Yeah, just look at those mustachioed Caucasian masks. Now, is that the captain from Captain and Tennille, perhaps? Or is it Luigi from Super Mario Brothers? Look, I say in for a penny, in for a pound. So when can we expect to see Malabar remove those masks from its shelves? Because don't know about you folks, but just the sight of those masks triggers the crap out of me. But again, this just shows how selective the left is when it comes to what it considers to be offensive during the Halloween season. So it is, we're told that a Pocahontas costume is verboten, but if someone wants to, say, dress up as a pregnant Catholic nun, well, you go, girl. And actually, thanks to some online retailers, girls can now dress up as their favorite feminist now. Wow, fun. The point here is this. There isn't anything that can simply be good, clean, innocent fun anymore. Certainly not to the killjoys on the left who seem bent on twisting everything innocent into something sinister, something racist. Halloween sure is a scary time of year, and we think that has more to do with leftists than it does with any so-called culturally appropriated costumes. For the Rebel.media, I'm David the Menzoid Menzies. Hey folks, you may have heard we have an all-new fall lineup on the way. Please go to the Rebel.media/shows and check it out.